Hey everyone, and welcome back to Void Breach Part 2. Now we have just left the caves and we can talk to the girl. Hello, I'm Tabatha. Do you like to play in the caves too? Hello, Tabatha. Not really, I don't. I'm glad to have left them. They are the most fun place. Did you know there are ghosts in the depths of them? Ghosts? No, likely I haven't seen any inside. Aren't you afraid of ghosts? Afraid of them? My best friends are ghosts. They are funny and witty, and they like to play hide and seek. Wouldn't a ghost have a clear advantage in hide and seek? Oh, I'm a very good seeker. They have to try real hard to hide from me. Only problem is the last time we played, I left my toys in the caves and can't remember where. If you happen to find them, could you please bring them back to me? Ah, yes, I could. Just so long as I don't run into any nasty ghosts. Oh, thank you, thank you. Can't wait to have all my toys back. They are somewhere deep in the caves. So we just go back and we look at the mushrooms. The stench is odious, but it's worth checking if Tabatha hid her toys here. Yes, here it is, a collection of dolls. How she withstood the smell is beyond me. Okay, now I need to get out of here and return them to her. And if we talk to her again, here you go, I found your collection of dolls. Next time try not to leave them among those noxious mushrooms, that can't be good for you. Oh, thank you sir, this doll is Mary, and this one is Lola, and this one is Martha. I would like to have Martha as a gift for your trouble. Thank you. Martha's possessed, you know. She's got the ghost of a real fruitcake inside her. But she's fun, so I bet you will like her. Martha's ghost loves to play games. Ah, thank you again, I suppose. So, we have a doll. And now let's go back. We need to give it to the ghost in the haunted house. And we also need to do one more thing. So let's go back here. There's something I missed, and that might be the most difficult part of the game. I did not really understand that this was a passage. I thought it was a wall or something. But if you go up, all the doors I've come across have been locked or jammed. I have followed the staircase to the spire. And if we talk to the gargoyle, like the others, you have fallen from the sky. I don't remember falling. What is this place? I could say this is a world out of bounds, a world unset, but what would it really tell you? Not much. We are the undesirables, the ones loathed in dreams. I still don't understand. I was told the Witch King lives here and that he may have my daughter locked up. Do you know anything about that? The Witch King is gone and his prisoners have run away. He was banished by the entity for plotting against her. The entity? I keep hearing about that. Who is it? The entity is the one who dreams. She is watchful from beyond the bounds. The whole universe is her crystal ball. She sounds powerful indeed. Don't want to run into her. Tell me more about yourself, your role here. I was the Witch King's most trusted servant, his plumber. You, a plumber? I shouldn't be surprised at that, really, with all the things I've seen here. I don't presume you have seen where the Witch King's prisoners have gone? No, but since you may need these on your quest to finding your daughter, here, take my plunger. Since I'm out of work, I won't have need of it anymore. So, we got the plunger from the gargoyle. And let's visit the haunted mansion. And let's give the toy to the boy. Noah, you're back. Yes, do you want this so you won't feel too alone? You said you are bored with your other toys. Oh, thanks. I like it a lot. And guess what? While you were away, I have met another ghost. His name's Rory. Rory says he used to work in a bar. Sadly, something awful happened to him and now he's in the morgue. That's tragic. What happened to him? He doesn't remember. He says he got drunk and somehow swallowed the key to the bar. Can you believe that? Poor Rory. Anyway, thanks for the teddy bear, Noah. You are very kind. So we've got a clue that we will need later. And let's go back through the cave. And let's move to the north and talk to this lady. Hello, girl. Have you seen the woman in this picture? Nope. I see. Do you think you could let me pass? I will when I'm done with my candy. It's important that you allow me to pass. You got any candy, mister? No, I haven't. No candy at all? That's a pity for you then. But we do have that fruit. You can use it on her. Hey, I got you some candy. What's this? You chew on it, it's like gum, sweet and rubbery. Hey, that's not bad, mister. Rather nice, actually. Oh, ouch, my feeling, it's out now. My tooth hurts so bad. And if we use this herb, I got you something for the toothache. What's this? A bunch of clove leaves. Their oil will take the pain away. Just chew on them. You sure about this oil? The taste is pungent, but it should help. It's yucky tasting alright, but the pain is gone. Well, I'll be going now. I'm all out of candy and I'm rather tired. Goodbye, mister. So let's leave. What's this? A woman appears from the bark of the tree, clad in leaves and vines. Hello, Savior. You are about to meet the ageless entity that menaces this world. You must destroy her. I'm no savior. You must be confusing me with someone else. I'm here looking for my daughter. You can't free her without defeating the entity. I was once a powerful dryad with a vast forest of my own. I was ripped away, taken from my forest. Now I live under the entity's angry, watchful eye, bound to this miserable tree against my will. If you can defeat her, I'll be free. You and your daughter will be free. Why is she doing this? What is she gaining by imprisoning us here? Oh, she's envious, you see, envious of my emerald forest stretching from ocean to ocean. No one ever has such a forest to call their own, and she could not bear it. So she brought me here, bound me to this tree. I can no longer enjoy my bountiful forest. My loss is her joy. I don't know what to do. You have to help me. You have to help Darius. You have to help your daughter. We are all victims. Go down this path, find her in her garden, and destroy her. I'll see what I can do. Let's follow the path. And this is... this little girl is the entity. Let's save the game. I'll tell you why in a bit. Hello, are you alone here, little girl? I am. You seem surprised. I was expecting someone else, not as young as you. You're not safe here. You should go home. Not safe? I am home. This garden is your home, but the entity, I'm looking at it, aren't I? You are. You don't look ageless. Are you going to do as the dryad asks you to? Are you going to kill me? You heard us? I hear what the winds tell me. I'm not going to kill you, of course not. I only want my daughter back. I was told you keep her as a prisoner. Prisoner? No, your daughter was separated from the others she came with. She's far away. Do you know where she is? I do, but you can't get to her, not on foot. I would have helped the two of you if it hadn't been for the damage you did. The damage I did? When I dream, I see through the veil to other worlds, far away. My mind expands. If I want something to happen, I make it so. Your machine hummed in my dream, made my dream collapse around your daughter. Then she was gone. I did not mean for it to happen. Your dream? The resonance chamber. Oh. It wasn't an astrophysical phenomenon we detected and studied, but a biological one. It was you. Your mind. Your daughter is stranded in a world between the voids. Her friends died here, on this world. I saw the bodies. When I ran the experiment the second time, the same thing happened, didn't it? That's how I ended up here? Yes. If you brought us here, why can't you send us back? Your machines weakened me. Your second experiment was worse than the first. But don't lose hope. Oh, there's hope to cling to? Destroy the box that hums. It came when you ran your first experiment and landed in a nearby world that has recently been swept by the destructive nebulous void. That world is now stuck in time. I would destroy the box myself, but when I get near it or dream of it, I faint. What wicked devices you created. The box that hums, you must mean the Tesla magnet. Evelyn was equipped with it to conduct experiments. There's a tear in the void to the west. Go there and it will take you to that world. You'll find your magnet where it landed, in a bar's restroom of all places. Find a way to get it to the sewers, where the void has receded to. There it pulsates and can demolish it. Go now, go quick. Will you then send my daughter and me back? First, you'll need to promise me something. When you return to your world, destroy the machines that caused all this. Never construct them again. So we have two options, and that will alter the ending of the game. We will show both of them, so let's agree. I'll do it, you have my word. Thank you, the path to the west is open. Before I go, one more question. The dryad believes you brought her here to punish her. Darius thinks he's a prisoner too. Is that true? The dryad was greedy and selfish, called a whole forest her own, and refused entry for people fleeing disaster. I had to intervene. Darius' crimes were just as bad. So they were right. You took them from their homes to punish them. Someone had to do something. I don't expect you to understand. Noah, go now. The humming is getting worse. The path to the west is open. So let's go west. And now, it's very cold all of a sudden. Let's move on to the right. Through a tear to another world. So we are outside the bar, we cannot get inside, it's locked. But the boy told us that Rory, a friend of his, died by choking on the bar key. Astonishingly, I have found all the doors I've come across inside the hospital to be either locked, blocked, jammed, or barricaded. Only the door to the morgue was open. It's eerily silent here. Now if we look at the corpse, there's a body under the sheet. I can tell by the uncovered dead bluish legs. There's a tag attached to the toe. It reads Rory Dixon. The tag attached to their toe reads Rory Dixon. Tim said he met the ghost of a man called Rory. Supposedly, he has the key to the bar where the Tesla magnet should be. Worth checking. If we click it, so the key should be in his mouth or throat, according to Tim. I can't believe I'm about to do this. I'm clenching jaws, inserting hand. I got the key. Thank you, Rory, for keeping it safe. Now, if you don't mind, I'm out of here. So we have the key. And let's shirt sleeve, use it on the door. It fits, I can get into the bar now. The bar is stuck in time. I would expect it to smell dead and stale like the rest of this world. That the beer left on the counter should reek of formaldehyde. Instead, it smells alive with a whiff of perfume, albeit a cheap one. I wonder what happened here. Is the girl entity responsible? Someone as powerful as her could bring ruin to an entire planet, stop time itself. Or maybe she's innocent, like she wants me to believe. Whichever it is, I'll do as she asked. I'll find the Tesla magnet and destroy it. After all, only she can get me home. I wish I didn't have to rely on her. Now, she said the magnet was in the restroom. Best start there. So if we click the left door, we see the magnet. I shouldn't take the Tesla magnet with me. I need to think of a way to get it into the sewer system. Now if we try to flash it, that's a good idea. I can flash the Tesla magnet into the void lurking in the sewers. But it seems like the toilet's clogged. Damn. So we just use the plunger. It's working. And now let's flush the toilet. The Tesla magnet is small enough to fit down the pipes and reach the sewers, where it will be destroyed by the void. I should return to the entity now. And let's go back. Talk to her. I no longer feel it, that burning sensation in my mind your device caused. I have destroyed it, flushed it down the toilet to the sewers. You were the one who helped devise it, but thank you for getting rid of it. Will you keep your word? Will you send my daughter and me back home? Yes, I never had any intention of keeping you here. What about the others you keep as prisoners here? They must stay. Do not entangle your fate with theirs. I hope you'd let them go, but I guess there's nothing I can do about it. I'm ready to go back home. Would you, what's the word, teleport my daughter here from whatever world she landed on? You will meet her back home. Before I send you back, I remind you of the promise you made to me. Destroy your machines that harm me in my dreams. I will destroy them, but others will rebuild them. I'll just have to deal with them when they do. But do warn them that their science can be harmful to others, harmful to me. I will warn them. Alright then, get ready now, Noah. You might feel a slight discomfort. Farewell. And now we're back into our lab with our daughter. Evelyn, you're back. Dad? Where have I been? I only remember a cold, dark cave. Am I really home? You are. Are you alright? Are you hurt? I'm fine. What happened? I got separated from the rest of the team. Are they here too? No, sweetheart, they didn't make it. They're dead. Oh, Dad, that's terrible. Julian, Dave, gone. I'm so sorry. I don't understand what happened. I came after you. I had to find you. I met this alien on the other side. An alien? We were wrong. What we believed were space-time waves were really the neural oscillations of this powerful alien. We were unintentionally interfering with her dreams, her mind, and this brought about everything that followed. Dad, that sounds like madness. Oh, I know what it sounds like. I can barely comprehend it myself, but it's not over yet. There's one more thing to do. What is that? The alien agreed to send us back home safely if I promised to destroy my lab equipment. She's kept her word. What are we going to do then? I'm going to keep my promise. The test we had harmed her, caused her pain. Oh, I see. We didn't know. We never would have done it if we'd known. Are you okay with this then? But rest a moment to recover. You've had quite an ordeal. No, Dad, I don't think this can wait. Let's go then. Let's do it. So that's the first ending of the game. And so this is the second ending. Some dialogue changes. It's not over yet. There's one more thing to do. So we lied to the entity. We said we would destroy our equipment. What is that? The alien agreed to send us back home safely if I promised to destroy my lab equipment. We cannot do that. Why would we? The test we'd run harmed her, caused her pain. If we destroy our technology, others will rebuild it. She has kept her word, but can we trust her? Look what happened to Julian and Dave. I hear what you're saying, Dad. She's such a powerful alien. Her powers make her dangerous. You're right, we shouldn't stop experimenting. At least, we are aware. We can limit the use and we'll be prepared. We will be more careful next time. There must be a next time. So, those were both the endings of the game. I hope you enjoyed this walkthrough, and I'll see you very soon.